What's up, y'all? So welcome to my 6 months post-op top surgery video. I know it has been a while. I haven't made a video since 2 weeks post-op, and bruh, life happens. You know, what do you want me to do? We're in a pandemic. It's rough out here. It's rough out here, but I'm back, you know. I'm here with the video, so don't hate on me too much. I came with it. I came back with it. But yeah, without further ado, this is my chest and how it's progressed. Day one surgery to about 5.5 months.
Five hours later.
What's up, everybody? Just out here. This is day 5 post-op. So far, everything's pretty good. I'm just waiting to get my fucking drains out. I get them shits out on Monday. It is currently Saturday.
So right here, this is me revealing my chest myself because they pushed the date to get my drains out back. So I revealed my chest myself. Right here, you can see the scars are still super raised, very raw, my nipples as well. The scab around my nipples started to fall off. That's why you see it's more pink. Right here, you can see the scars super, super rugged. The first month definitely was the worst month. That's when everything looked so raw and graphic. So here about 3 weeks in, the scars are looking a bit better. My nipples looking more like actual nipples. 1 month in, these are the silicone scar strips that I have on. Bro, what the hell I'm doing here? 2 months is really when my chest started to come together. You can see the scars kind of becoming more skin-like and not so separate from the rest of my body. Something about 3 months though. 3 months really is when my chest was, oh, let me just be quiet.
Alpha.
So this right here is me just showing my ability to work out. As you can see, my chest muscles are being flexed. Like I can really do anything. I have no restrictions. This is me back at the gym when it was open for like 2 weeks. Look at the pecs. Look at the pecs. Yup. Yup. This is me flexing how my chest looks from the side, and I was drinking Gatorade and it was very frozen. Yep.
So I'm pretty sure y'all just saw the video. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. I don't know if you guys can feel how surreal it is and how crazy it is that like I had surgery and my chest looks really good. It looks really good. I'm just so thankful. The whole process honestly was not even that hard. I'm not gonna say it wasn't a struggle at times, because it was, but it could have been so much worse. Being trans is not an easy thing, and I'm so thankful that my transition has literally been positive for the most part. You know, for the most part, I've got what I wanted. My quality of life is like times 10, like times 100. Like I'm good. Anyways, okay, I'm good, blah blah. All I did honestly, like as care, scar care, chest care, post-op, put cocoa butter for all you other trans guys or trans mass people that will get top surgery or already had it, whatever. Cocoa butter is your best friend. I put cocoa butter and lanolin cream on my scars. They're very moisturizing things, so you want to get something that's going to be moisturizing to your scars, because the thing I feel like that makes them not like heal well, I thought homeboy was about to come tell me something, but I guess he's just on his walk. But anyways, but yeah, cocoa butter and lanolin cream, just something really moisturizing. I put that on my scars like every night. I know cocoa butter works because I used it on other scars and then those scars like faded away. So that's how I know it works. But for sure, just put something that's gonna moisturize them every night. That's pretty much it. Just moisturize them and you'll be good. Second of all, working out is also a great help. Even my surgeon had told me, I already knew, you know, working out is gonna really develop your pec muscles. I mean, it's cool if you just want a flat chest with no muscle, that's on you. You'll probably get muscle too if you're on testosterone, you know, just from like growing, I guess. But if you really, really, really like want to see the best that your chest can basically become, then I suggest working out. I look like I don't work out, but I do. just helps the process go by faster. Like, you'll see your chest look like a chest quicker if you do take care of your scars as well as work out. But yeah, so I'm almost 2 years on T, and then I'm 6 months post-op top surgery. Honestly, I've just been living life like I kind of forget sometimes. And I'm not that I want to remind myself that I'm trans 24/7, but when I go past milestones, I feel like I need to celebrate them, you know, and just give myself credit, like, you made it here. I don't wake up and say, oh my god, like, I'm this many days on testosterone now, like, oh my god, like, no. I just kind of wake up and I go about my day as I should. That's what my whole transition, this is what I do it for, so that I can wake up in the mornings and just go about my day and not have to be like, damn this, you know what I mean? You know, I'm sorry, I've been living too comfortable, I don't put videos out, but hey, I'm back because I'm back. That's it. Okay, the video, this is y'all watching the video, all right? So I don't want to hear nothing else because I made a video, all right? So I just finished recording the video and I forgot I didn't take my shirt off and show y'all how my chest looks. So I'm gonna show y'all. Okay, my shirt's off now. So this is what my chest looks like. I have actual titties. Like these are the titties I wanted to be born with, bro. But I got them now, so I ain't even tripping. But yeah, let me bring y'all in closer just so you can see the scars and like how I was talking about how they used to be all raised and like was rugged, you know what I mean? So let me just show y'all that. So as y'all could see, this is the scars. As well as my nipples, my pec muscles, all that. Y'all could see. But for my nipples, this one, I don't think it's ever gonna get fully regained color. I'm not tripping if it doesn't though. I really don't care. This nipple looks great though. That's my favorite nipple. Honestly, no, it's not. I like both. But yeah. My chest has healed really nicely. I don't want to toot my own horn or anything, but like I love my chest. It literally looks so good.
This is what y'all wanted to see and I literally forgot. But at least it's in there, yo.
Better late than never. Better late than never. Okay.
But yeah, anyways, still, y'all have a great day. Protect your local black people, protect your local black trans women, please, because, bro.
Y'all probably thought I was joking, but deadass, the amount of black trans women that get killed is just ridiculous, bro. Protect your black trans women, the fuck?
Okay, so yes, it is a different day, but I just want to end the video off here. I want to say thank you to everyone that's watching my stuff, supporting me, all that. I recently just hit 101 or 100 subscribers, so pretty psyched about that. Really, thank you so much for everyone. 100 subscribers, yo. That may sound like little to some people, but to me, that is absolutely crazy. That like 100 subscribers, yo. 100 people fuck me. Like 100 people clicked the button and said, I fuck with this dude. I'm going to subscribe to him, follow him, keep up with him, keeping up with Christian. Like 100 people. I don't understand. Y'all don't understand. But it's okay, cause I understand. But yeah, thank y'all. Definitely, y'all will be seeing me more. That is a fact. That fact. 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 It's a fact. No, it is. It is.
Say bye.
Later. How does everyone know I am? Get the Mac out the back of this all black truck and gold macaroni, I am. These niggas ain't gonna lonely, I am. Tell the cast, get it, y'all, treat it like a little pony, I am.